At the installation stage, we focus on several things: IP address deployment, setting ring or chain parameters, and VLAN configurations. The first step is to connect all the Ethernet switches as a daisy chain topology, as these blue wires. Then we connect the end devices to these switches, then turn on the power. Now we activate the first software, MSConfig. As you can see, here is MSConfig dashboard. There are many quick select icons on the top. In the middle, there is a list of connected devices. Also, we have detailed information on the bottom. In order to set up these devices, first, we need to search them. To do this, we can click the broadcast search icon and select the device type, then click the search. MSConfig will search all the connected devices by different types. As you can see, the search devices are listed in the table. After a few seconds, the search will finish. If a device is locked, which means it's password protected, it will appear with a Go lock. To unlock one or more devices, we can select these devices. Then click the icon Unlock Device. Enter the password and click OK. Then these devices is unlocked. As you can see, the lock will turn in green, and that means MSConfig can set the parameters to these devices. If you right-click on the left window and select Auto Grouping, all the devices will be sorted into their default groups, such as wireless AP, secure router, Ethernet switch, and even IP camera. Also, you can create your own group by clicking Create Group. Now we start to configure IP addresses. First, select all the devices. And click the Network Setting icon. And select the static type. Also, enter the started IP address. And we set the increment as 1 and click Generate. Now, as you can see, the new IP address are shown in the table, and we can sort these devices by many types, such as MAC address, model name, serial number, and we can use the up and down button to move your device. After adjustment, we can click Configure and also click OK. Now you can see the process and also the new IP address will appear in the table. In few seconds, you can finish IP address assignment for all devices. Now we focus on the network infrastructure, that means the Ethernet switch. And we start to configure the redundancy protocol setting. First step, we select the devices. And then we click the redundancy protocol setting icon. As you can see, there are 4 different redundancy protocols: RSTP, MOXA proprietary protocols, Turbo Ring V1, Turbo Ring V2, and also Turbo Chain. And we select Turbo Chain page and set the head switch and tail switch. In the head switch, we set the head port is number 11. The member port is number 7. Also, In the tail switch, the tail port is number 11. And the member port is number 7. In the member switches, the member port is number 7 and number 8. Now we click OK. Before we start to configure Turbo Chain, we have to click Analyze Topology to analyze the link sequence between devices and prioritize the order from farthest to nearest. The farthest device will be configured first, then the second farthest, and third farthest. In the end, the nearest one will be configured. If we don't follow this kind of order, the farther one may not be successful configured because the near one finished the setting and disconnect the far one, especially when we setting the redundancy protocol on the connected ports. The analyze topology function can make sure that all operation and settings will not be lost by disconnection. After click OK, as you can see, the redundant protocol settings can be configured one by one. Sometimes, you may want to deploy VLAN settings on multiple switches. To do this, first, we select the devices and click the icon VLAN setting. Then we select the type as a trunk port and enter the PVID 100. And also click to port number 7 and number 8. And click copy to port. And also we click apply. And analyze topology. After click OK, as you can see, the setting process is going on. MSConfig will check the connectivity of each devices every 10 seconds. As you can see, after setting the VLAN on the connected port, that means MSConfig cannot access these switches because it has a different VLAN group now. And this switch will be shown in red on the device list. But don't worry about this. After all the VLAN settings are deployed, all the switches are in the same VLAN group, and eventually MSConfig can access these switches. We'll now finish the installation stage. All the switches and devices are deployed and installed at a few sites. As you can see, these two Ethernet switches are connected as a turbo ring, and these four Ethernet switches are connected as a turbo chain, and IP camera and end devices are connected to this turbo chain.